So here's the question. Why did Labor's climate change and energy minister, Chris Bowen, post a video about nuclear energy on Friday morning and then swiftly remove it from all his social media platforms within hours? The answer, it was untruthful, a misrepresentation of the facts, and it diminished Australia. Let's take a look. Here's why Chris Bowen thinks next generation zero emissions nuclear energy is a bad idea.
It's really three reasons.
His first reason.
Nuclear power is very expensive.
Nuclear, expensive? Not for consumers it isn't. Unlike Chris Bowen's theoretical models, actual data from electricity grids around the world tell a very different story. I was in Ontario, Canada in February, and the minister showed me how nuclear energy brings the price of electricity down. I was presented with similar evidence when I visited Japan. And it's the same again for South Korea. To these countries, it's not theory. They have all the same energy sources as we do in Australia, plus nuclear. And what they conclude is when nuclear is in the mix, electricity costs and therefore prices to consumers go down. It helps explain why 32 nations today have nuclear energy and they want more. And there's another 50 countries across the world who are looking at introducing nuclear energy for the very first time. Meanwhile, here in Australia, our electricity prices are soaring, and yet the minister responsible is lecturing the rest of the world about the economics of their electricity grids. Chris Bowen's second reason.
Nuclear power stations being built today are facing huge delays.
But he didn't mention this year's host of COP28, the UAE, did he? In the UAE, they have added 3 new reactors in the last 3 years to their grid. A fourth one's on the way. 12 years ago, the UAE had 0 nuclear energy in their mix. Next year, they'll have up to 25%. You can always find selected examples of delays on any infrastructure project. But before criticising projects in other countries, Chris Bowen might like to remember that under his watch, the Snowy 2.0 hydro project has been delayed, won't be up and running until the end of this decade. The Kurri Kurri gas plant has been delayed by another 12 months. And then we have his plan for over 22,000 solar panels installed every single day. 40 wind turbines every single month, and then up to 28,000 kilometres of transmission lines carpeting regional Australia. Let's see how he goes on his delivery timeline for those. Chris Bowen's third reason, waste.
We've struggled here in Australia to store the nuclear fuel rods from our one small medical reactor.
To his credit, he acknowledges Australia already is a nuclear nation with a nuclear reactor already operating 30 kilometres outside of Sydney CBD. On waste, nuclear nations have already solved for this. Whether it be on site, at plants, central repositories, above ground, below ground, I have personally gone and inspected these different options. I can assure you Chris Bowen hasn't. All the nuclear waste ever produced from commercial nuclear power plants could fit onto one cricket field, about 7 metres high. Chris Bowen doesn't tell you that. Such is the density of the fuel. Besides, waste is only waste if you don't use it. Next generation nuclear technologies include designs for feeder reactors, which use the waste to produce energy. But none of this is going to stop Chris Bowen from running his scare campaign. What astounds me most is Chris Bowen forgets that under the AUKUS arrangement, Prime Minister Albanese has agreed for Australia to manage the spent fuel and waste that will come from our future fleet of nuclear propelled submarines. To be clear, I have every confidence in Australia doing this. Every confidence. But Chris Bowen clearly does not. Not only is he a minister in the government, but he sits on Cabinet's National Security Committee? What sort of message is he sending to our AUKUS partners? Chris Bowen's video was a cheap political attack, and the Australian people deserve better. They deserve an honest, mature conversation about the challenges, the opportunities of Australia's energy future. The minister might speak for the Australian Labor Party, but he does not speak for the Liberal National Coalition. When it comes to Australia's future energy mix, the Coalition believes in an all-the-above approach where every possible technology is considered. It's on the table. We don't want to see technologies pitted against each other. It's about working out how technologies can complement each other as part of a broader energy mix. A mix that can keep prices down, keep the lights on, and make sure that we have energy security in this country. As for next generation zero emissions nuclear energy, we'll continue assessing this technology and be open with the Australian people as we do.